was going underwater with $3 and 6 dimes. Yeah, you may laugh, 'cause you did not do your math. Like 1, 2, 3. Damn, y'all feel it?
Hey guys, welcome back to Spice Plug. We're here behind the scenes of a photo shoot with Krishana, Visuals by K on Instagram. We're here on the west side of the Bronx by the Fort Tyron Park. So let's go see what she's doing behind the scenes of this photo shoot. And Lauren, look at me. Yeah, that's fire. Wow. What's wrong with you? Look at me. When did you start like doing photography? Like, was it a hobby for you at first, or was it something that you just always like, it was just a passion? Or tell me a little bit about that, the background.
I started photography when I was about 14, 15. Mm-hmm. I got my first camera in high school. It was like the Nikon Coolpix.
I was gonna say, was it the little disposable ones that you used to get at Kmart? No. And then you go develop the photos?
No, it wasn't that one. It was like a little like point and shoot camera. You mm-hmm. couldn't even like change the lenses. Wasn't a DSLR at all.
Okay.
I started that just taking pictures during lunch mm-hmm. at school of my friends and all that stuff. And then I started posting on Facebook mm-hmm. and a photographer who I now work with on and off. Her name is Kesha Lambert. She kind of saw that I was posting and was like, oh,
she reached out to you.
She did reach out. She was
and
like,
how old were you, if you don't mind me asking?
I was like 15.
15? Mm-hmm. And a professional photographer decided that they were going to reach out to you to work with you.
Yes. She's also a family friend. So okay. She kind of knew and like mm-hmm. saw my pictures and she was like, oh, I didn't know you were a shutterbug.
Right.
And she was like, oh, you should come work with me. So she had a studio in New Rochelle mm-hmm. and I started working with her as an intern and then kind of worked my way up. So I started assisting for her and then eventually second shooting and then lead shooting. So now kind of.
So you got, would you say that you got most of your experience there, or did you go to school for photography? Like how did that come about?
I didn't go to school for photography when mm-hmm. I started college. I went to Manhattanville College in Purchase.
Okay.
And when I originally started, I was a bio major, and then...
Okay, to go from a bio major to taking photos.
Right. I wanted to be a vet. I'm a big, like, animal lover, okay. but then I switched over to business, and I did studio art as a minor, and so, like, I took film photography, mm-hmm. I did a little bit of graphic design, mm-hmm. but I never took any digital photography classes, so it's all kind of just based off of experience. But
so
I
you kind of self-taught yourself?
Yes, but I can say
sometimes
that,
that's where the best growth comes from, when you teach yourself.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Exactly, but I can say that a lot of my experience and a lot of the things that I have learned have come from Kesha.
Ooh, shout out to Kesha.
Her, absolutely, shadowing her has like been essential. Like, honestly, I probably wouldn't have become a photographer if it wasn't for her, so.
Kesha loves
She's
you.
She's amazing. We love you.
Okay. Camera, would you consider it to be like your purse? Do you bring it outside with you every time you leave the house? Is it like, listen, I can't leave the house without my camera because there's a world full of beautiful stuff out there and I need to be ready. Like, do you always bring your camera with you when you leave?
So, as of lately, mm-hmm. It is something that I've started to bring with me. Mm-hmm. In the past, it was something that I've always wanted. Like, there'll be times where I'm out and I'm like, damn, I wish I had a camera on me right now, you know? But I just recently got this camera.
Mm-hmm. What kind of camera is this?
It is the 5D Mark IV.
Okay, sounds pricey.
This is my baby. It was pricey. But this is my baby. Blood, sweat, and tears, bro.
Yeah.
Like, dead serious.
Shout out to you, though.
Thank you. This was one of my goals for 2018.
Listen, you're investing in yourself, so exactly. It starts there.
Yes, and that's very important when you have a small business, and sometimes I have to remember that, you know, like, it's mm-hmm. an investment, it's worth it. I'll see a return on investment at some mm-hmm. point in time, you know, but... like I said, it's always something that I've wanted to do. I've always wanted to just have a camera on me and... there'll be a moment happening and I'll pick up my phone and just be like, nah, I gotta capture this, or like my camera, whatever, you know, like yeah. the time when I was in Texas a couple mm-hmm. weeks ago and I captured that jazz
right
guy,
that was the moment where you stepped back and really like, you know, appreciated it for what it
no,
was or
I
no?
couldn't even like
really?
I walked up to him listening to him playing the saxophone mm-hmm. and I was like, damn, I need to capture this. I took my camera out and immediately started shooting, you know? Right. Whereas, like, most people would be like, hey, like, let me sit back and actually just listen to this
person. Yeah, but that's still a part of who you are, so it's going to be natural for you to do that anyway. Like, right. That makes who Krishana is, visuals by Kay. You exactly. always, you know, are envisioning stuff, I'm sure.
Yeah.
So,
just, there's something I constantly have this, like, need to just capture things. I can honestly say that being from the Bronx has taught me how to create product from my environment as opposed Ooh. To becoming a product of my environment,
right.
if that makes sense.
Of course.
In the Bronx, there's a lot of beauty, mm-hmm. but it's hidden.
It's
you
hidden.
Know, it's in so many hidden places. Like, mm-hmm. when you come to the Bronx, I'm not going to lie to you, it's struggle. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what you see. You right. see struggle. You see hustle. You see, like... Mm-hmm. New York, mm-hmm. you
but
know?
there's such beauty in all of
exactly.
that.
Exactly, there's so much beauty in all of that, and I think that has been one of my biggest inspirations for my work. Mm-hmm. A lot of my photo shoots, a lot of my photos take place mm-hmm. outdoors, and mm-hmm. that's because I like to use my environment. You know, mm-hmm. like I really genuinely love to see my subject mm-hmm. in these hidden, overlooked places, and mm-hmm. it just becomes beautiful. You know.
Krishana, thank you for having us shadow you today behind the scenes of your photo shoot. Do you have any other up-and-coming projects that we can look forward to? Or?
I do have some mm-hmm. upcoming projects, possible
in the works.
Show in the works, Ooh. Yes. So stay tuned. You may see that very soon.
Where can we stay tuned to? Where can we find you?
So my website is www.visualsbyk.com. And then my Instagram handle is visualsbyk_. Mm-hmm. So that's where you can find me.
Can I go and see some photos on there?
Absolutely.